going to my course EDOP, and this assignment has been done by me. I have completed this thing, and I'm moving on to how to mark attendance. And for that thing, I want you people to be very alert, because what I'm going to do now might be something new. How many of you have seen that when you were on add activity and resource, let me go back to add activity and resource and show it to you. Now, I've been using it. So if I go to add activity and resource, see, these are the things I have activated. Can you see this? Attendance. How many of you have not found it in your Genomio through add activity and resource? Let me know. Are you showing very small? Okay. Is that fine? How many of you have actually found this thing, attendance or bibliomancy? There are many plugins that I've activated from the backend, and I'll be talking to you. Sudoku is also there, but I'm not going to tell you how to play it. Hotpot is there, H5P, a wonderful thing is there. Quiz is there, which is already there with you also. WebEx meeting can, they have it. Zoom and WebEx, they have not yet released the API. Moodle is going to welcome them if they allow an integration. But sometimes for safety reasons, they don't allow an integration with a third party resource. Not there in Genomio. So you want me to bring it? Piyush Mathurji, should I get it for you? Okay, done. Done, sir. And this is a secret tip, everyone. I'm going to my course, my site actually. I'm going to, because you are going to enable the plugins for your site. Every course you will create will have the same things there. I'm going to site admin, everyone. Please remember, I repeat, site admin, site admin, site admin. Site admin, turn the editing on. These things are required to be on your tips. Add activity and resource. So this is my site admin, everyone. This is slightly different from Moodle Cloud because it is an older one, that is a new one. If you take backup of this course, then this backup will have sort of some troubles uploading on a higher version. That is what it happens. Like if you bring the 500 rupee note of the older world, so that might not be accepted easily. So I go to plugins, site admin, I go to plugins. In the plugins, I go to manage activities. In the manage activities, you see what has opened now. It is already a blue eye, active for me. I can hide it. Hide. Now see, I go to my course. I'll prove that it has been hidden. I guess by now you people have understood. It was a three-step thing, everyone. Wasn't it easy to activate the plugins which are not actually visible to you? I'll repeat, man. First, I'll show you that I don't have attendance. As you people don't have attendance. See, you don't see attendance here. Assignment B, C. This is ordered, alphabetical order, sorted. So there's no attendance here, everyone. Let me go back to site admin, site admin, site admin. After site admin, go to plugins, plugins, plugins. In the plugins, please go to manage activities, manage activities, manage activities. In the manage activities, you have your own world in front of you. You want attendance to be activated. Go here, toggle from show to, like show now. It was hide. Now I can hide it. So this is attendance. And there is nothing like save here. It is just about toggling from yes to no, no to yes. I go here. Let me refresh it once, though even the refresh won't be required. I'll go to add activity and resource. And here we are, the winners. Here is attendance, everyone. Is that fine? Got it, Piyush Mathurji? Everyone, site admin, plugins, manage activities, and then go to the plugin you want to activate. Attendance, activated, add. I'm adding the attendance now. This is the same thing, you add it, attendance. For attendance, for, this is the complete attendance module heading. This is not the lecture that we, attendance for English. Generally, we have got this kind of thing. So the description for, this is the description of the attendance module. grading, grading, I'm not talking about restrict access, I'm not talking about, and you know, I have skipped restrict access for some reason. I'll come back to the what is restrict access is. In assignment, if you want to restrict that this particular topic, topic means the one we were doing, this assignment should open on a particular date, then you set a date that assignment will be open to them. I gave you two things. In assignment, if you remember, in the assignment thing, when we were working on it, we had set a date when the submissions will start. Suppose you don't want them to even see the statement of the assignment, the file, one of our teachers had said, the file, the additional file, you don't want them to access, you don't want them to enter here. You don't want them to enter here. So let me go to edit settings and show you how you can restrict access to the complete subtopic. The main topic can also be restricted, the subtopic can also be restricted. I don't want my students to even see what this particular attachment. So what I'll do, I'll go to the same thing now. I go to restrict access, add restriction, date, and let me check. Availability was set on 1st of June. So they will be able to see it on 31st of May. On 31st of May, this particular information, the Word document will be available to them. However, that is a tough thing. You can make it 30th also. Like, you can decide these dates yourself. Save the course. I'll tell you what changes happened now. If I would have, now see, restricted, this particular thing cannot be clicked by the student now. The student can, I can click here because I'm the admin. Let me turn editing off here. I'm toggling you, like making a jump from attendance module to assignment restriction. I'm just making it like, see, this is blue, accessible. This is blue, not blue, gray, not accessible. It means this particular thing is not accessible to the student. Other than this thing, they can't see anything in it. It means I restricted this. On 30th of May, this will open. Only then they will be able to see the things which are inside it. And then the submission date I have already set. So this is a restriction till 30th of May. I guess you people have got it. I won't use the word understood. Restrict access. We are not doing anything to attendance. What I did, attendance for English 3 for Praveen Kumar. Display it here. Attendance for English 3. Save and return to the course. Save and display. Let me show you what save and display is. We have been returning to the course again and again. Now this is save and display, everyone. Save and display means you get into the thing you have added. If I make it save and return to the course, I go to the same place where I was adding these things. The add activity and resource and something. So inside the thing you want to go see, I added it again. So here it is. These are two attendances. I click on turn editing on. I want to delete one of the attendances, or I can rename it also. Attendance for English. Attendance for Hindi, and Hindi can also be typed, everyone, nothing to worry if you people are worried. Any language which can be typed these days is possibly can be entered here. Okay, I'm just like clarifying this thing, not a part of our agenda for now. So this is the attendance 3 we have decided, attendance for English 3, and I click here. Now this is the inside of it. Here it is, everyone, if you people are able to understand it. If you remember, our course starts from 28th, we had set the date for the course. If you see, if I go to course, this is our course. I go to edit settings and check out the dates from when it had started, because this is 29th of May. Can I mark attendance for 28th of May? No, because course did not start. So when I'm going to add my sessions for attendance, I need to know that my classes have to start from 29th of May. And 29th of May is a Friday. I go back to attendance. Attendance has been added by all of us. In assessment module, we have added attendance through add activity and resource. We gave it a name, we gave it a description, and we simply save it. We saved it and displayed it, and then this thing came. I'm adding a session now. No session has been added yet. I'm adding a session, a class for which attendance has to be taken. Now, from which date I want to start this, I'll say I want to start my class from 30th, no, 29th, 30th, 29th. Time of the class, I will be the one who will be taking a 9 a.m. class till 10 a.m. Any doubt till here? What I did, I clicked on add attendance through the add activity and resource, gave it a name, gave it a description, and then saving display, and this thing appeared. Then I decided I have to finally see in timetable there are, if sessions are being given, then I have to put a session here. Only then I'll be able to, I guess, do something. So here it is, 29th of May is the date to start. 9th, description is being served. Sir is for my students, not for you. For you, I'm another student of yours. Multiple sessions, do I take sessions again and again? So yeah, I take classes on Friday. Repeat the session. I take classes on Friday. I take them on Wednesdays also. Yeah, these are the 2 days it has been allotted. And you say, I'm saying repeating every 1 week. I'll say, yeah, they repeat every 2 weeks. So let me make it, keep it one. Repeat until, my course is till when? My course is till June. So repeat them, but I'm going to take the classes till 19th of June. And that's it. So what I have done, this is the date from when the session is going to start. I've kept it intact. I have set the time for my lecture, 9 to 10. I have decided that because my lecture gets repeated every day, I have got a lecture on Monday, I've got a lecture on Tuesday and Wednesday. So I select these days here and till which date my session is going to run here. Student can mark their attendance on their own. Everyone, will you please give an answer to this? If checked, students will be able to change their own attendance status for the session. What is your take on it? Do you want the students to mark their attendance on their own? And what about you people? Then you are marking your attendance yourself. You all are marking your attendance yourself. Nobody is saying roll number 1, 2, 3, 4, 007. So still, we won't like leave it to them because it will be an application based thing. So see, life is all about going this way and that way sometimes. Everything is good. Everything is rational. Everything is context based. So for now, I'm not going to allow my students won't be allowed to do this. And automatic marking is also there. You see, when you say allow marking to be completed automatically, if yes, students will be automatically marked depending on their first access to the course, everyone. If set unmarked at the end of the session, any student who have not marked their attendance will set to the unmarked status. So it is, you explore it further. I'm saying I won't allow them. This is a very nice feature. Students can have a password also. If set, students will be required to enter this password before they can set their own attendance status for the session. If empty, no password is required. A QR code is also there, everyone. A random password is also there. Every student will get a random password. A QR code they can scan, attendance can be marked. These many features are there, which is a bundle, a big thing for all of us. Not getting into this, but let me click on show more. Okay, show less. Done. Now I'm going to add it. Before that, I'm revising. I added it through add activity and resource, but before that I had gone to site admin, manage site admin plugins, manage activities, activated the plugin called attendance. You can activate all other plugins. Sudoku is also there, everyone. Many games are there, so you can activate it. The moment you activate it, then add it through add activity and resource, put description, title, and then save and display, and this happens. Go to add session, decide the date from when you are going to start, decide the timing of the lecture, 9 to 10, 9 to 11, 10 to 11, 12 to 1, your choice. Give a description of the class. You can even add an image of you say the course which is there. You can easily do this. Let me add this thing for the this course. It will be visible to the teachers, to the students actually, not the teachers. I'm just adding this image. This image will be added to the description, and calendar event for session something. It will be added to your calendar also on your dashboard. If you will see where we are, okay, on your dashboard, if you people will see, this will be there. Here it is. Now I'm moving on adding it. Attendance is being added, everyone, and you will see the magic. Here it is. This is the image which got added to every lecture. Any clarification, significant clarification required? See, 7 sessions were successfully created. If you count those 3 days, like Friday and I guess see 29th, then 3rd of June, then 5th of June, Wednesday, Friday, then Wednesday, then Friday, then Wednesday, then Friday, and then nothing. And if I want to mark attendance, let's keep this image for now. Let's go here. This is the take attendance button, everyone. So I'm going to highlight it for you. This one, this is the class, this is setting, and this is delete for attendance. So these are the things I have to tell you. This is quite a small thing to do though. Add a session, another session you want to add, add another session for the another unit. So for every lecture you can take attendance. You can take attendance in the beginning also. So this is the description page, and I have to expand it though, and let me go, and I'm adding the attendance now for another lecture that I won't do. I'll go to sessions and show you attendance. I'll show you how it looks. I'll go to one of my courses. See, I click on play. Play means this icon of play, and all my list of students will come. Present, on leave. This is the exemption thing, and A is absent. Late is there, not leave that way. The present, late, E, and E is exempted, and exempted, and then A, the OD thing. So you put here, and then you save the attendance. Attendance is marked. Remarks can also be given for every student. So this is here. In Amity, when we used to like manage the intranet, it is called Amazon. These kind of things were there on Amazon, and I wasn't aware that because that is a big resource made by the university itself. I was never aware that such a resource is freely available. Now this is almost the same interface which was used by them, and that was an advanced one though. So this is here, and let me go back to the. I'll show you how the students' lists will look. I'll go to my courses. I've got one course in which I've got a few students added. 1, 2, 3. Understanding virtual teaching through Moodle. Attendance. Have you people watched the movie The Pursuit of Happiness? Or Dead Poets Society? Or To Serve with Love? Or The Bicycle Thieves? Or these are the movies that teachers should watch. Or A Good Lie is also there. So this is attendance, everyone. Wait a second, let me find out whether participants are there in this course or not. Yeah, these are the participants, everyone. Let me start attendance thing. I'll show you how it looks when the students are there. Add a session. I'm doing it with a course in which students are there. Description. Is a test timing from 9 to 10 a.m. or you say that falls under the M thing. I'm not going to multiple sessions, but still I'll select a Friday because every Friday it should happen. Take until June and add. Now this is added, and you can see all Fridays in June from 29th of May. I click here and I will see all the enrolled students here. Can you see this, everyone? It means these are there. Set status for all. I can mark all present, all this, all this, all this. Now these are the people here. I can do this, I can do this, I can mark this, I can put a remark also, and let me display all of them. Do not do paging, all 7 pages together so that I can show you how many students are there in it. So these are the people. Their email IDs will be displayed in front of it. They will get attendance updated. Moodle application, everyone, your students can use the application which is called Moodle app. So here it is, everyone. I guess we have been able to probably wander like a lonely cloud.